About 16 years ago, I experienced an unforgettable Mother's Day. I was a divorcee and a mother of a preschooler. I spent the weekend at my parents' home a couple of hours away. When a beautiful bouquet of lavender roses arrived, I assumed they were for my mother. Wrong! They were for me. Finally, I thought, I have a gift to accompany the handmade Crayola-laden cards I had been receiving from my toddler. A gentleman I'd recently met at work sent them to me. I was on an emotional high. I'd just spent a wonderful weekend celebrating with Mom and was holding the first Mother's Day gift I had ever received from a man outside of family. Finally, the time came to prepare for the drive back to my humble living quarters. Heading out my parents' front door, I thought of the lavender roses I would be putting on display in my home. However, I got no further than the front porch before realizing my car was no longer roadside or by the wayside. It wasn't even outside. It was gone. Stolen. Although some young daredevils may have stolen my vehicle, they couldn't steal my joy. My joy wasn't wrapped up in material things. I had just had the weekend of my life. I had spent time with my family and had experienced the spark of a new relationship which would later result in marriage. I wasn't about to let a stolen vehicle throw me into some depression. Moms, for Mother's Day, some of us may receive a bouquet of weeds from our elementary schooler. Others will receive pieces of folded construction paper with little illegible scribbles, and a few may even get an unpleasant surprise. Hopefully a stolen car won't find its way into your Mother's Day memories. However, we can all be thankful for the little things we have. Let's choose to have a day where our joy is unshakable, our demeanor is pleasant, and our smiles are genuine, simply because we know that our children are our special gifts from the Lord.